So a very good morning, student. I welcome you all once again for the lecture series on the subject that is railways, airport and waterways. So this subject is related to the students of the civil engineering department. Till now we have covered the lecture one and lecture two in three different lectures, right? Lecture one and lecture two was actually divided into part one and part two. In this particular lecture, we will focus on the lecture three. And let me tell you what will be the contents of this lecture three. This lecture three is all about the rails, different types of the rails, defects and creep in the rails, right? So I welcome you all for this online lecture series. Now we will look towards the contents of the lecture. Okay, so if we talk about the contents of the lecture, so this lecture, this particular lecture will consist of rails, requirements of rails, types of rail section, defects in rail section, creep of rails, theories of creep, effect of creep, remedies of creep and coning of the wheels, right? So in this lecture, we will cover these all parts one by one. Okay, so we'll start with the first one, that is rails, right? So moving to the next slide, and the next slide is all about the introduction part of the rails, right? So let us talk about the rails, right? If you remember, in previous lecture, I told you about the basic definition of the rail, right? I told you that what is it? If you still remember, I told you that the rails are the girders, right? It are acting as a steel girders for the purpose of carrying axle load, right? So the rails on the tracks can be considered as a steel girders for both the purpose of carrying axle load. Okay, the rails on the track can be considered as a steel girders, okay, which is used for the carrying the axle load. Now there are different types of rails, but genuinely flat footed rails are mostly used in the Indian Railway. If we talk about the Indian Railway, then these flat footed rails are mostly used in Indian Railway. So if I will talk about the rails, then I will tell you that rails on the track, it can be considered as the steel rail. See, we know that the trains, actually jo trains hain, unki jo wheels hain, right, wo kya hoti hai, steel wheels. And this steel wheels, they come into the contact with this steel girders. Okay, now, so we can say that when this is coming in the contact with the steel girders, it means it is used for carrying the axle load or transmitting that axle load to the sleepers, right? So rails on the track can be considered as a steel girders for the purpose of carrying the axle load. And what kind of rail is mostly acceptable or mostly used? It is flat footed. It is flat footed rails, right? Now coming to the next point. Next point is about the functions of rail. Till now I have told you the basic definition of rail. So whenever anyone asks you what is rail, just tell them rail is a steel girder used for the purpose of carrying the axle load, and the rail which is mostly used in Indian Railway is flat footed rails. Okay, now coming to the functions of rail. So one by one we will look towards the different functions of the rails, right? So first function is that it provides hard, smooth and unchanging surface for the passage of heavy moving loads with minimum friction steel rails and steel wheels. देखो होता क्या है कि जो आपका रेल है, राइट, जो आपका वैगन्स है उसमें कौन सी व्हील्स होती है? वो स्टील व्हील्स होती है, राइट. तो जो स्टील व्हील्स हैं, तो उस केस में हमें जो ट्रैक्टिव रेजिस्टेंस है उसको क्या करना होता है, उसको मिनिमाइज करना होता है। तो सबसे पहला जो फंक्शन है उस केस में, जो सबसे पहला फंक्शन है वो फंक्शन रेल का ये होता है कि इट प्रोवाइड द हार्ड स्मूथ एंड अनचेंजिंग सरफेस फॉर द पैसेज ऑफ हैवी मूविंग लोड्स विद मिनिमम फ्रिक्शनल स्टील रेल्स एंड स्टील व्हील्स। बिकॉज व्हाट हैपेंड, दिस स्टील रेल्स and these steel wheels, when they come into contact, then there should be the minimum friction, right? So the function of the rail is to provide hard, smooth and unchanging surface for the passage of heavy moving loads with minimum friction steel rails and steel wheels. Okay, clear? Now the second point, the rail material should be such that it gives minimum wear to avoid replacement and failure. So next requirement kya hai, next function kya hai, the rail material wo aisa hona chahiye so that there should be the minimum wear. Okay, when steel wheels and steel rails comes into the contact, then there will be a property of wear and tear. But we have to minimize that property. We have to minimize that wear and tear property. Why? Because zyada se zyada wear and tear hoga, to hame har baar use replace karna hoga. But minimum wear and tear hoga, to jo replacement hai aur jo failure hai, uska jo span hai, wo kya hoga? Wo minimize ho jayega. Theek hai? Then you don't have to replace it every time. Okay? So अल्टीमेटली क्या करता है, वो वियर एंड टियर को कम कर देता है, राइट? सो मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, रेल ट्रांसमिट द लोड्स टू द स्लीपर्स। अभी मैंने आपको फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन यही बताया था कि रेल्स आर व्हाट, रेल्स आर एक्टिंग एज अ स्टील गर्डर्स व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू ट्रांसमिट द हैवी एक्सियल लोड फाइनली टू द स्लीपर्स, right? So rail transmit the loads to the sleepers and consequently reduce the pressure on the ballast and formation below. Kal maine aapko pura formation ke bare mein bataya tha, right? Aap agar purane wale lecture ko yaad karo to usme maine aapko kya bataya tha, components of a track, right? So components of the track start kahan se hota hai, rail part se, then it is connected to the sleeper, then it is connected to the बैलेस्ट, राइट? इतना तो क्लियर है ना, इतना पार्ट क्लियर है। तो अब क्या करता है, जो हमारा एक्सल व्हील लोड है वो ट्रांसफर किसको करेगा, वो हमारे रेल्स को, वो अपने लोड को किसको ट्रांसफर करता है, रेल्स को ट्रांसफर करता है। अब ये रेल्स क्या करता है, ये ट्रांसमिट किसको लोड करता है, स्लीपर्स को करता है। तो जब ये स्लीपर्स को ट्रांसमिट लोड करेगा तो क्या होगा, जो बैलेस्ट है और जो फॉर्मेशन होता है उसके नीचे, ठीक है, जो हम बॉक्सिंग करते हैं पहले से, उस पे उसका प्रेशर क्या होगा, अल्टीमेटली रिड्यूस हो जाएगा, राइट? तो जब उस पे प्रेशर रिड्यूस हो जाएगा तो क्या होगा, वियर एंड टियर क्या होगा, वो रिड्यूस हो जाएगा, राइट? तो इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन व्हाट वी हैव टॉट सो फॉर इन दिस लेक्चर, इज दैट व्हाट इज द बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेल, इज अ स्टील गर्डर फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ कैरिंग द एक्सल लोड, व्हाट आर द फंक्शन ऑफ रेल, function of rail is to provide hard, smooth and unchanging surface for the passage of heavy moving loads. The second one is that it should be such that there should be minimum wear and tear. And the third one is that rail transmit the load to the sleeper and consequently reduce the pressure on ballast and formation below. Okay, now the definition of the rail and the function of the rail is clear. Now what are the different composition of rails, matlab wo rail steel bana kiska hota hai, uski composition kya hote hain, usme materials kaun se use kiya jata hai, because it plays a vital role, right? Now there are two things. Sabse pehli cheez hai ordinary rail. To first hum baat karenge ordinary rail ke bare mein. To jab hum ordinary rails ke bare mein baat karenge to iska jo composition hota hai wo kuch aise hota hai. Isme carbon content it is about 0.5 to 0.68%. So carbon content is 0.55 to 0.68%. Manganese, that is Mn, it is 0.65 to 0.9%. Okay, 0.05 0.652 0.9%, and silicon is about 0.05 to 0.3%. Silicon hai 0.05 to 0.3%. Sulfur is 0.05% or below, and phosphorus is 0.06% or below. तो ordinary rails में आपको कुछ बातें ये याद रखनी है कि जो उसके रॉ मटेरियल्स हैं, जो उसका कंपोजिशन है, वो बेसिकली इन किन रॉ मटेरियल से बना होता है, क्या उसका कंपोजिशन होता है, आई मीन उसके जो कंपोजिशन होते हैं वो होते हैं कार्बन, मैंगनीज, सिलिकन, सल्फर एंड फॉस्फोरस, और उसके डिफरेंट डिफरेंट क्या होते हैं कंपोजिशन होते हैं. जैसे कार्बन का 0.55 टू 0.68% है, मैंगनीज का 0.65 टू 0.9% है, सिलिकन का 0.05 टू 0.3% है, और सल्फर का 0.05% और बिलो, एंड फॉस्फोरस का 0.06% और बिलो, राइट. सो दिस वॉज फॉर द ऑर्डिनरी. तो ऑर्डिनरी रेल्स का कंपोजिशन रेल स्टील का ये होता है. नाउ विल टॉक अबाउट द फॉर रेल्स एट पॉइंट्स एंड क्रॉसिंग. तो ये तो था कंपोजिशन ऑफ रेल स्टील for the ordinary rails. Now next is about the points and crossing. When we are using that particular rails at points and crossing, then what will be the different composition? So that different composition are given on your screen. It is visible to your screen. Those are carbon content. So carbon content will lies between 0.5 to 0.6%. Manganese, it will lies between 0.95 to 1.25%. Silicon, 0.05 to 0.2%. Sulfur, 0.06% or below. And phosphorus, 0.06% or below. Okay, so see, the materials, the composition is same, but uske percentage mein vary kar rahe, right? Because when we are using the same rail for ordinary rails, okay, then their carbon content is something different. And here the carbon content, manganese content, silicon, sulfur and phosphorus content are bit different, right? So these are basically the two types of rails, ordinary rails and for the rails at points and crossing. Now abhi tak humne dekh liya ki what is rail, what are the function of rail, what is the composition. Now the next important topic is about the requirements of rail. What are the different requirements of for an ideal rail? So one by one we'll also look towards it. What are the different requirements for a ideal rail? They should be of proper composition, okay, of steel, and should be manufactured by open hearth and duplex process. You have to know this. Okay, so the first thing is that they should be of proper composition of steel and should be manufactured by open hearth or duplex process. So jo composition hona chahiye wo kya hona chahiye, proper hona chahiye, aur uski manufacturing kaise honi chahiye, open hearth process se ya duplex process, right. Dusra kya hai, the vertical stiffness should be high enough to transmit the load to several sleepers under net, right. So the vertical stiffness should be high enough to transmit the load several sleepers under the net. Okay, so uska vertical stiffness hai wo itna hona chahiye ki it should transmit the load to the several sleepers under net, right. Now third one is rail should be capable of withstanding the lateral forces. वहां वर्टिकल स्टिफनेस की बात हुई, अब यहाँ पे जो आपका रेल्स है वो लैटरल फोर्सेस को रेजिस्ट कर लेना चाहिए. ओके, द रेल्स शुड बी कैपेबल ऑफ विदस्टैंडिंग द लैटरल फोर्सेस. लार्ज विड्थ ऑफ हेड एंड फुट इंडोर्स द रेल विद हाई लैटरल स्टिफनेस. ओके, द थर्ड पॉइंट इज दैट रेल्स शुड बी कैपेबल ऑफ विदस्टैंडिंग द लैटरल फोर्सेस and the large width of the head and foot indoors the rail with high lateral stiffness. The fourth point is that the head should be sufficiently deep to allow for an adequate margin of vertical बियर। देखो जो आपका हेड है, ओके, हेड पार्ट जो होता है रील का, तो वो अगर डीप है, इट शुड बी सफिशियंटली डीप, तो उससे क्या होता है, इट अलाउ एन एडजुकेट मार्जिन फॉर दी वर्टिकल बियर। ओके, तो उससे क्या होता है, वर्टिकल बियर जो है आपका वो मिनिमाइज हो जाता है। ओके, तो वियर एंड टियर पार्ट आपको बहुत फोकस करना है, और उसके लिए हमारा जो रिक्वायरमेंट्स है रील का वो ऐसा होना चाहिए कि वो आपके जो वियर पार्ट है और टियर पार्ट है वो मिनिमाइज हो जाए। राइट, नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट वेब ऑफ द रेल शुड बी सफिशियंटली थिक। नाउ वहां पे हम बात कर रहे थे कि हेड जो है वो सफिशियंटली डीप होना चाहिए, तो उससे क्या होगा, वर्टिकल वियर को एक मार्जिन मिल जाएगा, वो मिनिमाइज हो जाएगा। यहाँ पे हम देखते हैं कि वेब जो है वो रेल का वो सफिशियंटली थिक होना चाहिए, उससे क्या एडवांटेज होगा, टू बियर द लोड कमिंग ऑन इट एंड शुड प्रोवाइड एडुकेट फ्लेक्सुरल रिजिडिटी इन हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन। राइट, सो देयर आर टू थिंग्स, द हेड शुड बी सफिशियंटली डीप टू मिनिमाइज द वर्टिकल बियर, एंड द सेकेंड वन इज दैट वेब ऑफ द रेल शुड बी सफिशियंटली थिक to bear the load coming on it and should provide adequate flexural rigidity in the horizontal plane. Okay. Now the next point is that foot actually jo rail hai uske different parts hote hain, head, web, foot. The foot should be wide enough so that rails are stable against the overturning, especially on the curve. So, अभी तो first I told you that head should be deep. Okay, I told you in previous lecture, in previous slide, I told you about the head. I told you about the web. Okay, that the web should be thick and head should be of deep. Now, coming to the other part is that foot. So foot should be wide enough. So foot should be wide enough so that rails are stable. So that rails are stable against the overturning, especially on the curve. Okay. So wear and tear part कैसे कम होगा? जब आपका head है, जो head है rail part का, वो क्या होगा? Deep होगा. Okay. और आपका जब foot जो है, वो wide होगा, लेकिन चौड़ा होगा, तो उससे क्या होगा? The rails will be stable against the overturning on the curve. Now, some other parts are there. Bottom of the head of rail and top of the foot should be so shaped as to enable the fish plate to transmit the vertical load efficiently from head to the foot at rail joint. तो आपका जो bottom part है head का, the bottom of the head rail and top of the foot should be so shaped as to enable the fish plate. Fish plate क्या है? These are the rail fastening, right? When we have to connect the rails with the sleepers and when we have to connect the two rails in the series, then we are using this fish plate and the fish bone. So the bottom of the head of the rail and top of the foot should be so shaped so as to enable the fish plate to transmit the vertical load efficiently from the head to the foot at rail joint. Okay. Next point is that the center of gravity of the rail section must lie approximately at mid height so that maximum tensile and compressive stresses are equal. So the center of the gravity of the rail section should be approximately at the mid height so that the maximum tensile and compressive stresses are equal. क्या होता है कि जब आपके रेल सेक्शन में जो सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी है वो अगर मिड हाइट पे लाई करेगा तो आपका जो टेंसाइल और कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेसेस है वो क्या होंगे, दे विल बी न्यूमेरिकली इक्वल। द टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द रेल पीस शुड नॉट बी लेस देन 72 केजी पर एमएम स्क्वायर। इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, ओके, दैट द टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द रेल शुड नॉट बी लेस देन 72 केजी पर एमएम स्क्वायर। सो ये रिक्वायरमेंट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि उसका टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ टेंशन में वो वीक नहीं होना चाहिए और उसकी टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ मिनिमम 72 केजी पर एमएम स्क्वायर होनी चाहिए। राइट, ओके, So, class, till now we have covered introduction part of rails, composition of rail steel, then what are the different requirements for an ideal rails. Now we will look toward the different types of rail section. So this slide is basically about the different types of the rail section. Okay, so if we talk about the different types of the rail section, the different types of the rail sections are double headed rails, that is DH rail, right? Double headed rail, that is DH rail. The second one is that bull headed rail, that is BH rails, and the flat footed rail, that is FF rail. Now, in the first slide only, I told you that in Indian Railway, if we talk about the Indian Railway, the most used rail is flat footed rail. So, jo maximum time mein jo rail hum use karte hain, wo hai aapka flat footed rail. When we talk about the Indian Railway, okay. So, teen tarah ke rail sections hain. Pehla hai double headed rail, that is DH rail. Dusra hai bull headed rail, that is BH rail. And tisra hai flat footed rail, that is FF rail. Okay. Now, let us talk about some history about these different types of the rail section. What was there in beginning, that the rails used were double headed. So we were using a double headed rail in the beginning of a tumble section. Okay. So I will show you the different sections of the rail. So starting mein kya hota tha ki we were using the double headed. So double headed rail is actually something like this. Okay. This is actually something like this. You can see. Actually, this was a double header. So, what was this resembling? This shape was actually resembling like a dumbbell. Okay, you can see that on a screen. It is resembling like a dumbbell. So, hum double headed rail ko dumbbell section rail bhi kehte hain. Dumbbell section, right? So, dumbbell section rail kaho ya double headed rail kaho, both were the synonyms. Okay, so double headed rail were used in the beginning. This double headed rail were used in the beginning, and this double headed rail was also termed as a tumble section. The idea behind using of these rails was that when the head was worn out in course of time, the rail can be inverted or reused. But the experience shows that such indentation are formed in lower table, due to which smooth running over that surface at the top was impossible. So what was the idea behind using this tumble shape rail was that, just suppose we are using this tumble shape, just suppose this part has been worn, okay, this part has been worn. So what we'll do, if this part is worn out, then we will invert it. Isko ulta kar de, to ye part hum use kar de, right? So, but this practice is obsolete these days. Why? Because identification were formed in the lower table, due to which smooth running over that surface at the top was impossible. So double headed rail jo hai, jo DH rail hai, wo kis shape ko resemble karta tha? It was resembling the shape of, like a dumbbell. You can see here, it is resembling like a dumbbell. So dumbbell shape ka use karne ka ek prime objective ye tha ki hum agar pehla jo uska head hai, agar wo worn out ho jayega, to isko hum invert karke use kare. But kya hota tha ki aapka jo lower part hai, uspe identification ki wajah se wo wear and tear ho jata tha, aur smooth running over the that surface was not possible. So this become the obsolete distance. Here you can see the different sections of the rails. Okay, different sections of the rail. This is the figure 1. This figure 1 is about the double head. So DH rail is here. You can see the DH rail. DH rail is resembling like a dumbbell shape. This is your head. This is your bell. Right? So in DH rail, this part was about this, both the part, lower table and upper table. It was of 70 mm. So what was the dimension? You can see that it was 7 PM. So the dimension was of 7 PM. So it was consisting of two parts, that is upper table and the lower table. And the dimension was 70 mm. Okay. Now, this was your web part, and the entire depth was 152 mm, and the entire depth was 152 mm. Okay. Now coming towards the bullhead. Okay, bullheaded में क्या होता था कि जो आपका upper part है वो foot के comparison में ज़्यादा thicker होगा. वो foot के comparison में ज़्यादा thicker होगा. You can see that foot part is only 64 mm, but it is more than it 64 mm. तो जो आपका head है और foot है, ये दो part होता है आपका किसी भी rail section. तो जो double headed होता था उसमें दोनों foot हो चाहे head हो वो क्या कर रहा है, वो एक जैसा result. लेकिन इस में क्या होता था, जो आपका बुल हेडेड रेल था वो इट वाज लाइक कि एक बुल के शेप की तरह रिजेंबल करता है, राइट, बुल की शेप की तरह रिजेंबल करता है. तो उसका हेड पार्ट जो है वो उसके फुट पार्ट से ज्यादा होगा, इनलार्ज होगा, राइट. नाउ कमिंग टुवर्ड्स द फ्लैट फुट. फ्लैट फुटेड में यू कैन सी दैट द हेड पार्ट इज ओनली 66.68 mm, बट the foot part is 136.53 mm, and the entire depth is 142.88 mm. तो आपका जो तीन रेल सेक्शन है, तीनों के अलग अलग पार्ट्स हैं, जैसे कि डबल हेडेड, बुल हेडेड, फ्लैट फुट. तो डबल हेडेड का मतलब ये हुआ कि जो फुट है और जो हेड है वो एक जैसा रिजल्ट है. लेकिन जब बुल हेडेड में आए तो जो हेड पार्ट है वो फुट से थोड़ा इनलार्ज है. बट कमिंग टुवर्ड्स द फ्लैट फुट, तो इस केस में जो आपका फुट है, जो आपका फुट है, इट विल बी द इनलार्ज पार्ट इन कंपैरिजन टू द हेड पार्ट. सो थ्री थिंग्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर व्हेन वी विल टॉक अबाउट डबल हेडेड, बोथ द सेम. बुल हेडेड, हेड इज मोर देन द फुट. And flat-footed, the foot is more than the head. Okay. So this was about the different rail sections. Now we'll talk about the bull-headed. Okay. In this, we saw that double-headed. Why we are not using double-headed rail? Because of the identification formed in the lower table, due to which smooth running over that surface at the top was impossible. These are the different sketches of the different rail section, namely double headed, bull headed and flat footed. Now we'll talk about the bull headed rail. The next evolution was about the bull headed rail, in which the head is made little thicker and stronger. You can see here the head is little thicker and stronger than the lower part by adding more metal to it. So what we do is that the head part and the foot part in the double headed was identical, but during bull headed what we'll do is that the head part is made in bit thicker and stronger than the lower part. And how it is made? By adding more metal to it, so that even after wear it can withstand the stresses. So objective behind that it was that it can bear the stresses even after the beer. Okay, now coming the next evolution was flat footed, and this is actually used in the Indian railways now. So the most used Indian rail is the flat. Okay, it was initially thought that flat footed rail can be fixed to the sleepers directly and would eliminate the need for chairs and keys required for the bull headed. Actually what was the problem with bull headed rail was that usme hame fixers ki zarurat padi, but ye idea lagaya gaya ki agar we are using the flat footed rail to usme humko different chairs or keys ki requirement nahi padi. But however it was observed that heavy train load caused the foot of the rail to sink into wooden sleeper. To remedy this, steel plates are used between the sleeper and the rail at joints and other important places. So the idea behind this it was that it would eliminate the need for the chairs and keys required for the bullet. But what was the inference? That heavy train load caused the foot of the rail to sink into wooden sleeper. To remedy this, steel plates are used between the sleepers and the rails at joint and other important places. Okay, so the first one was double headed, then came your bull headed, then was your flat. Okay, now we'll talk about different comparisons of the rail section. Now, as we know that there are three different rail section: flat footed, bull headed and double. So what I have done, I have divided into three columns, and the first column is about the point of comparison. The second point, the second one is about the flat footed rail, and the third one is about the bull headed rail and double headed. And in the present scenario, only flat footed rails are used. Double headed and bull headed are obsolete these days, right? So moving towards their point of comparison, the first point is strength and stiffness. So if we'll talk about the strength part, so flat footed rail have more strength and stiffness for the same weight, both laterally and vertically. Okay, so the strength part is, the strength and stiffness are more both laterally and vertically for the flat footed. These have less strength and stiffness. Okay, now laying and relaying. Fitting of these rail is simpler, so can be easily laid and relaid. No chairs are required. The fitting of these rail, actually the fitting, first thing, the pehli cheez hai strength. So strength or stiffness jo hai wo laterally or vertically dono zyada hai kiske liye, flat footed rail ke liye in comparison to double. जब लेइंग और रीलेइंग की बात करते हैं तो जो फिटिंग है रेल्स की वो क्वाइट सिंपलर है फॉर दी फ्लैट फुटेड रेल. वी कैन ले ऑल्सो एंड रीले ऑल्सो वेरी इजी. ओके, बट द फिटिंग ऑफ द डबल हेडेड एंड बुल हेडेड रेल आर डिफिकल्ट एंड वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग एंड दे आर सपोर्टेड ऑन द चेयर एंड वी नीड टू सपोर्ट ऑन इट द फिक्स्चर नोन एज चेयर. सो दिस वॉज लेइंग एंड रीलेइंग. Now the next point is about arrangement at points crossing and at sharper curve. Okay, so the third point of comparison is about the arrangement at points crossing and at sharper curve. The arrangements are simpler and easier. Again, the arrangements are simpler and easier for the flat footed. The arrangements are complicated and difficult. Now moving to next point, alignment and stability of the track. In this, the impact of rolling wheels affects the fitting, and loosening of fittings disturb the alignment and gives less stability. So agar stability point of view se baat kare to jo aapka rolling wheels hai uski impact ki wajah se jo fittings hai wo kya hoti hai wo loose ho jati hai aur uski wajah se jo alignment hai wo disturb ho jata hai. So it gives the less stability. But in the case of double headed, these rails when fitted on chairs provide a more solid, smooth track and better stable alignment. Okay, so alignment point of view se jo aapka double headed hai aur bull headed hai wo better stability alignment deta hai. Theek hai, initial cost, these rails requires lesser and cheaper fastening, so the initial cost is less. So initial cost is less for the flat footed. Why? Because the fastenings are very cheaper. These require more and costly fastening, because without the use of chairs and keys you can't fix the double headed and bull headed. So these require more costly fastening, and hence initial cost is more. Now talking about the rigidity, these rails can be used without bearing plates on the sleepers, as these rails are strong to withstand the vertical load, hence they are more rigid. Okay, अगर रिजिडिटी की बात करें तो जो फ्लैट फुटेड रेल्स हैं वो डबल हेडेड रेल के कंपैरिजन में काफी रिजिड होते हैं. बट डबल हेडेड रेल जो है, दीज रेल्स विदाउट चेयर्स कैन नॉट बी यूज्ड ऑन इंटीरियर टाइप्स ऑफ स्लीपर, बीइंग लेस स्ट्रॉन्ग अगेंस्ट द वर्टिकल लोड, हेंस दे आर लेस रिजिड. ओके, नाउ We'll talk about the inspection. Daily inspection is not necessary as no special risk is involved. So cost bhi iski operation cost bhi kam ho jayegi. But in case of BH rail and DH rail, daily inspection of the wooden keys is necessary. Replacement of the rail. In flat footed, the dog spikes have to be taken out in addition to fist bolt and fist plate to change the rail. अगर आपको रेल को चेंज करना है, रिप्लेस करना है, तो वी हैव टू टेक आउट द फिस्ट होल्ड एज वेल एज द फिस्ट प्लेट आल्सो टू चेंज द रेल. सो रिप्लेसमेंट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, बट इन केस ऑफ डबल हेडेड दीज रेल्स कैन बी चेंज इजीली बाय ड्राइविंग आउट द कीज एंड टेकिंग आउट द फिस्ट होल्ड एंड फिस्ट प्लेट विदाउट डिस्टर्बिंग स्लीपर. सो यू डोंट रिक्वायर टू डिस्टर्ब द एंटायर अरेंजमेंट इन द केस ऑफ डबल हेडेड. नाउ मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट. द मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट इज लो. Okay, because there will be no inspection required, so the maintenance cost is low. But double headed, it requires the inspection and the heavy maintenance cost. Suitability, we will talk about the suitability. These are more suitable due to better stability and economy, strength and stiffness. These are more suitable when lateral loads are more important rather than the vertical loads. Okay, so these are actually the points of comparison between the flat-footed and bull-headed rail. Now, these are, till now we have talked about different rail sections. So, we'll talk about the rail length of the different standard rail sections. So, we have different standard rail sections. We'll also talk about its rail length. See, the standard rail sections I have made the chart gauge wise. Okay, so the first thing is about broad gauge. Broad gauge matlab BG. Okay, so the rail section and the rail length is 13 meter. So the rail length we use is of 13 meter. Actually, jo broad gauge hai, usme teen rail section hum use kar sakte hain. Ek 60 kg per meter, 52 kg per meter, and 90 lbs per yard. Okay, so for every rail section, we have different types of section, and the rail length will be only 13 meter, that is 42 feet. Okay, and rail section are 60.34, 51.89, and 44.6. अब जब meter gauge की बात करें, तो इस case में जो आपका rail length है, वो कितना होगा? It will be of 12 meter. It will be of 12 meter. But in the case of narrow gauge, it will be also of 12 meter. But in the case of narrow gauge, we have only one rail section, that is 50 lbs per yard. But in meter gauge, we have three different: 90 lbs per yard, 75 lbs per yard, and 60 lbs per yard. ठीक है? तो notes में अगर हम देखें, तो except for 60 mr and 52 mr, all rails are designated in fps unit, but their dimensions weights are mr, metric rail kg per meter as per Indian Railway standard, and British rail lbs per yard as per revised British standard RBS. So, अगर हम Indian Railway standard की बात करें, तो हम कौन सा dimension use करते हैं? It is metric rail kg per mm. और British rail की बात करें, तो RBS, that is rail lbs per yard. Okay, तो जो ये metric आपका rail है kg per meter में, ये Indian rail के हिसाब से है. लेकिन जब ये LBS पर यार्ड की बात कर रहे हैं हम, तो ये रेलवे LBS पर यार्ड की बात कर रहे हैं, तो ये एज पर ब्रिटिश स्टैंडर्ड. तो देयर आर टू स्टैंडर्ड, दैट इज MR एंड LBS रिस्पेक्टिवली एज इंडियन एंड ब्रिटिश स्टैंडर्ड. ओके, नाउ in this lecture, this one will be the last topic actually. So let us talk about the different details of the standard rail section, and in tomorrow lecture I will talk about the different defects in the rail section. So till now we have covered the introduction part. Okay, till now we have covered the introduction part, that is rail, then the composition of rail steel, okay, for points crossing and for ordinary rails, then the requirements of the rails, right, then different types of rail sections, then the comparison between the different types of rail sections, then the standard rail sections and its different rail length. And the last slide is about the details of the standard rail section. So these are the details. That is, 90R rail section was considered adequate only for annual traffic about 10 gross million ton. Whenever I will use a word GMT, GMT ka matlab hua gross million ton. It speeds up to 100 km per hour and service life up to 20 to 25 years. So 90R rail section was considered adequate only for annual traffic for about 10 gross million ton. GMT speeds up to 100 km per hour and service life up to 20 to 25 years. 52 MR, that is 52 kg per meter, rails are suitable for use of speed of 130 km per hour and traffic density of 20 to 25 GMT. Again, GMT means gross million ton. Okay, so 52 metric rail, that is 52 kg per meter, rails are suitable for use of speed of 130 km per hour and density up to 20 to 25 gross million ton. Now, 60 MR rail, that is 60 kg per meter, rails are suitable for use up to speed of 160 km per hour and traffic density of about 35 GMT. So 90R rail, 52 MR rail and 60 MR rail. So iska jo different scenario hai use karne ka, wo aisa hai ki jo 90R rail hai wo adequate hai aapka 10 gross million ton ke traffic ke liye, and speed should be limited up to 100 km per hour and the service life should be up to 20 to 25 years. Lekin jo 52 MR hai, that is 52 kg per meter, the rails are suitable for use for speed of 130 km per hour and traffic density of 20 to 25 GMT. And when we talk about 60 MR, that is 60 kg per meter, rails are suitable for use up to speed of 160 km per hour and traffic density of about 35 GMT. Okay, so 90R rails, 52 MR rail and 60 MR rail is clear. Now you can see the details of standard rail section in use of the Indian Railway. And what are those? 50R, 60R, 75R and 90R. Okay, so agar hum British standard ki baat kare to usme kya hota hai, LBS per square yard, RBS. Okay, aur agar hum metric standard ki baat kare to usme kaun sa use karte hain, weight, kg per meter. Okay, so these are actually the details of the rail section. So 90R rail, 52 MR rail or 60 MR. So jab hamara jo annual traffic hai aur hamari jo speed hai uspe bahut zyada focus karna hoga, tabhi hum ye define kar sakte hain ki hame kaun sa rail section kis purpose ke liye use karna hai. Because agar hamari traffic 10 GMT hai to 90R rail suitable hai, aur agar traffic is about 20 to 25 GMT, then we have to use 52 MR rail. Aur hamara traffic agar traffic density hamara 35 GMT hai to humko 60 MR, that is 60 kg per meter rail use karna hai. Okay, so this is all about the details of the standard rail section. So introduction part, composition part of the rail section, right? What are the different rail section? Okay, what are the requirements for an ideal rail? Okay, in the comparison between the double headed, bull headed and flat footed, and what are the different length of that railway section, and what are the different railway sections which are available to us, have been discussed till now in this lecture. Now next lecture, that is the part 2 of the lecture 3, I will discuss about the defects in the rail section and the creep, wear and the theory of the honing on the wheels on the rail section. Okay, so thank you so much. Thank you for listening so patiently, and I hope you have enjoyed this entire session. So have a good day and